Should Wizard Hit Mommy? The chapter is written by John Updike, who was an American novelist, poet, short story writer, art and literary critic, and the recipient of Pulitzer Prize for fiction. His most of the fiction characters experienced personal turmoil and family obligations. This chapter deals with a very serious theme of good parenting, and it is about the father who tries to teach moral values through his stories. The story portrays a sharp contrast between the child's viewpoint and an adult's perception of life. It also involves the issues such as validity of parental authority, being true to one's inherent nature, and finding acceptability by the peer group. Let me introduce to the characters of the story. First one is Jack, who is the father of two little kids named Joanne or Joe, who is 4 years old, and Bobby, a two-year-old infant. He is the narrator within the story, who tells stories out of his imaginations and tries to inculcate values in his daughter. Claire is the wife of Jack, who has conceived for the third time and has been portrayed as a housewife, involved in household chores and expecting the husband to do his familial duties. The wizard, the wise owl, and the protagonist, Roger Skunk, are the characters within the story narrated by the father. The wise owl always had ideas to solve the problems of Roger Creature, while the wizard would cast his magic spell to grant the wishes of Roger Creature. Jack the father always narrated the story with a common storyline. His story portrays a creature whom he would call Roger. Roger would always face some problems, and the father would take the problems which he had himself faced in his childhood, thus mixing real life issues and fantasy world. Then father would tell that Roger Creature would approach the wise owl, who believes to have solutions to all the problems. The wise owl in turn suggests Roger to go to the wizard, who with his wand would cast a magic spell and solve Roger's problem. But he won't do it for free. He would demand money against the magic done, and the little Roger would not have the sufficient money to pay him. Again, the wizard would direct him to the place where he would get the money sufficient enough to pay to the wizard. The magic would bring him happiness and contentment. He would be surrounded with friends, enjoying games, and would return home, where mother was waiting for him and for the daddy, who used to come home from Boston. The father would describe the supper and end the story here. It was Saturday, and Jo would be difficult to deal with, as she would not fall asleep easily. Therefore, Jack the father began with the story session and asked Jo to decide which creature she would go for. As Jo was taught about Skunk in her nursery school, she suggested the father to create a story on Roger Skunk. Father thought for a while and began to narrate the story as a perfect storyteller. He told Jo that Skunk smelt very bad, and owing to this foul smell, other creatures would run away from him, leaving him alone. That pain of Roger Skunk was clearly visible on the father's face as he recalled his childhood humiliations. Thus we can say that the father reflected his reality face. On the other hand, the daughter could relate herself with Roger Skunk, as he had no friends and was left alone. Joe's mouth dropped down and she was almost crying. Joe got interested in the story. As she knew the base of the story, she asked the father, "Won't Roger Skunk go to the wise owl for the advice?" The father instructed her to relapse on the pillow and sleep. The story now onwards discloses chose reality phase, as at the age of just 4 years, she began to reflect her understanding of realities of life and started questioning, like, are magic spells real? Do spiders eat bugs? Is God really in the sky? Will Wizard die? Thus, we can clearly understand her maturity. Now we come to know the characteristics of the father as an excellent storyteller. He would try to give special effects to his story through his voice and by rapping on the windowsill. Jack's favorite voice was that of the wizard, and he would crush his face and with the eye movements, making it roomy, created the impact. Then with the impact, spoke the magic words, changed the stinky foul smell to rosy smell. The magic spell casted by the wizard filled the room with rosy smell, and the stinky skunk smelt rosy. At this moment, Jack the father observed the cheerfulness on his daughter's face and compared it with that of his wife seeking pleasure at cocktail parties. The Roger skunk was short of money, hence was instructed by the wizard to go to the end of the lane and turn around 3 times and look down the magic well to get the money for the wizard. Roger skunk did what was instructed to him, and then he came back to the place happily. He was very happy to see friends flocking around him, playing with him. This could happen on account of getting good smell of roses, but at the cost of losing own identity and originality. Joe was very happy to see Roger Skunk enjoying the life and thought that the story has a happy ending. But her father never liked women to take anything for granted. In that case, he told Joe to remain silent and let him speak the story the way he wanted. He continued by saying that after the merry time spent with the friends, Roger Skunk returned home, but was surprised to see mother asking him, was this awful smell? Roger Skunk told the fact, which annoyed her, and she immediately asked him to come with her to the wizard. Roger tried to put his view that this rosy smell has made him happy and creatures from all around would now come and play. But mother knew what to do. She took an umbrella and went back straight to the wizard and hit him on his head. Alas, the poor little Roger felt sad but was helpless. The rosy smell changed back to foul smell. The little girl felt so sad as she could empathize with Roger Skunk. She insisted the father to continue the story tomorrow with a twist that mother would be hit by the wizard. She was so desperate to alter the end that she chopped with her arms and kicked with her legs and called Roger's mother as stupid. We could see the daughter and the father in disagreement. The little daughter took the side of Roger Skunk and told father that because of the foul smell, he would be alienated and would not have friends. On the contrary, the father wanted to tell her that elders know what is right and they are the ones to decide for the kids. The father sternly told Joe to sleep, as he was worried about his wife, hence left the room to go and help her out. When he reached downstairs, he heard the wife sarcastically telling, "That was a long story." He was in an ugly middle situation, as he did not want to disturb his family peace. The sarcastic comment was painful. He was actually fulfilling his familial obligation, yet was passed a comment. She wanted him to share the burden of her household chores but the husband was busy fulfilling his duties as a father. Moreover, he did not want, as his wife wanted him to become. He wanted to justify his own individuality, which his own wife wanted to undermine. He visualized the woodwork as a cage, and he felt caught in an ugly middle situation. Through the story of the skunk, he made it very clear that he identified himself as the skunk, and the wizard was none other than his wife, Claire. He didn't want to change, but to live his own life. The theme or different issues raised in the lessons are, number one, it highlights difference of views of parents and children and how the views differ when it comes to deciding the kid's future. Secondly, the story portrays how parents want to live their life or fulfill their dreams through their children. They do not give freedom to their kids to have their own aspirations and ambitions. Next, the lesson deals with good parenting, that is how upbringing brings a change. Fourthly, the story raises a question, why one should not lose individuality, or in other words, why individuality is refused and frowned upon. Next, the father tried to tell his daughter that everyone is unique and this uniqueness should be prized and upheld. Another major learning is that adults should not impose their views on children. They should be allowed to express their opinions and views. Hope the storyline is very clear and you would be able to get the gist of the lesson through this video explanation. Thank you.